Welcome student to this lecture based on shock absorber and air suspension system used in automobiles. As you can see in this picture, there is a utilization of air suspension system. You will see here the application of airbags in air suspension system and the details regarding this type of system that we will learn in today's lecture, along with the types of shock absorbers. What are the learning outcomes of this today's lecture? Number one, we will learn about the layout of shock absorber and suspension system. After that, we will learn about construction and working of air suspension. We will learn function and types of shock absorber. After that, how is the construction and how is the working of telescopic shock absorber. Similarly, another shock absorber that we will study, that is called gas filled shock absorber. The main role of air suspension system is it supports the weight of the vehicle. It provides smoother ride for the driver and passengers, that is, acts as a cushion. It protects your vehicle from damage and wear. It also plays a critical role in maintaining self-driving conditions. It also keeps the vehicle, keeps the wheel pressed firmly to the ground for traction. It isolates the body from mud shocks and vibrations which would otherwise be transferred to the passengers and load. So this is a layout of air suspension system, and in this system you will clearly see there are various components. You will see here front and rear wheels, and in that between there is a use of compressor, air filter, relief valve. After that, leveling wheels that you can see. So air suspension system consists of or comprises of compressor supplying air to air tank, and in which the pressure is maintained between 5.6 to 7 kg per square meter. Airbags are utilized on each wheel. As load applied, airbags compressed, activating the leveling valve. You will see here the leveling valve. Air from the tank fills the compressed airbag and hence raise the level of the frame. Air from airbag bags get released as the load on chassis decreases. So this is another layout of this air suspension system, in which you will clearly see the airbags. Means you will see left front airbag, rear front airbag, after that left rear airbag and right rear airbags. Along with, you will see there is a compressor, relays, after that computers, ECU control, means electronic controller unit, that you can see here. So the air suspension system starts with the onboard air compressor, which gets power from the electrical system of the car and enables inflation of each bag. The compressor feeds high pressure air to each spring by using either polyurethane pipes or stainless steel tubes. In the air suspension, the compressor operates like any other pump. It draws external air in the storage tank, compresses it to high pressure and delivers it to other end. With the integration of controller, it guides the system about when to pump the air and what quantity of air is necessary. Such controllers can be manual or electrical in nature. So this is a distinction between the air suspension and the spring suspension. Spring suspension uses semi-elliptic leaf spring to cushion a load from road shock, as one of the most commonly used suspension system is a spring suspension, and spring ride consists of several layers of flexible steel strips referred to as leaf pack. The strips are joined together to act as a single unit. The long and narrow arch-shaped plates are attached to the frame of the trailer and resisting above the trailer's axle. As you can see, in case of air suspension, air ride uses a variety of valves, air lines and air spring bags in place of steel suspension. The flexible air spring bags are made from the woven and rubber like material. The air supplied to the air ride suspension uses the same air compressor and the air reservoir as a truck's braking system. So this way, this is in short the distinction between the spring and air suspension system. There are certain advantages of using air suspension. These maintain a constant frequency of vibration whether the vehicle is loaded or unloaded. Constant frame height is maintained. It helps to reduce the load while the vehicle in motion, that is dynamic loading, as the spring rate variation between the laden and unladen weight is much less. It gives smooth and comfort ride of the vehicle. The stiffness of the system increases with the increase of the deflection. So let us see about now second component, which is what is meant by shock absorber. Shock absorber are normally used in conjunction with spring and in particular with coil springs. Shock absorber serves the purpose of quickly damping the oscillations of coil spring caused by uneven wheel loads during travel on bumpy ground. The force introduced by the shock absorber opposes the force causing abnormal motion of the suspension at any particular instant. Shock absorbers are also called telescopic dampers. In principle, a shock absorber consists of cylinder and piston and hydraulic fluid working inside the cylinder. The upper end of the shock absorber is fitted with a suitable mount for connecting to the vehicle body or the frame. The lower end is usually provided with an eye which fits with a pin and forms a hinge connection on moving part like a wheel axle or control arm, as the cases may be. There are two types of shock absorber: mechanical shock absorber and hydraulic shock absorber. In mechanical shock absorber, the friction action of metallic disc is utilized to control the spring action, whereas in hydraulic shock absorber, fluid is used to resist the spring action. These shock absorbers are discussed in this. The mechanical shock absorber consists of two links which are connected with each other by means of pin. The other link is connected to the frame, whereas another link is fixed with the axle. A number of friction discs of different metals are placed in between the links. These frictional discs control the spring action due to their frictional effect and thus helping in absorbing the road shocks. This type of system has almost become obsolete due to its non-predictable damping characteristics. Hydraulic shock absorber. The hydraulic shock absorber uses a fluid which is passed through an orifice which resists the movement of the fluid. It is a resistance force that is created at this time which is used to suppress the motion of the spring. The hydraulic shock absorber are of following types: telescopic shock absorber, cam actuated piston type shock absorber and rotary valve type shock absorber. Shock absorbers are also classified according to following terms: classification by operation, single action shock absorber, multiple action shock absorber, classification by construction, monotube shock absorber, twin tube shock absorber, and classification by working medium, hydraulic shock absorber and gas filled shock absorber. So this is the figure which indicates telescopic shock absorber. You can see here the picture in which you will see the components E1, V1, E2, V2 means valve V1, valve V2. There are two tubes, tube number A and tube number B. So what we can observe here, how is the construction of such type of shock absorber? This type of shock absorber have two tubes, one inner tube shown by a symbol A and other outer tube shown by symbol B. There are two valves, one is shown by V1 and other is by V2. The valve V1 is connected with the piston rod and free to move vertically inside the tube A, and the valve V2 is fixed at the other end of the tube A. Oil is filled inside the tube A between the valve V1. At the initial condition, piston, or we can say valve V1, is at middle of the cylinder. The annular space between the tube A and B is half filled with the oil. There are two eyes of the shock absorber, which is shown by E1 and E2. E1 is connected to the chassis frame and E2 is connected to the axle. Let us see now, after that, the working. When the vehicle comes across a bump, the IE2 tends to move upward. Therefore, to absorb the bump wall, V1 start to move downward, which compress the fluid trapped between the wall V1 and V2. This will pressuring the wall V1 and V2. Thus, oil starts to move from upper side of the wall assembly through the wall V1, and also some oil move in the annular space between the tube A and B through the wall V2. This process converts all the vibration energy into fluid action and absorbs shock. When the vehicle rebound, the wall V1 starts to move upward, which again pressuring the wall V1. Hence, it open again and oil start to flow below the wall V1. During its upward movement, it also sucks some oil from the annular space between the tube A and B. Thus, vehicle gets its initial condition. So this is a practical pictorial view of telescopic shock absorber, in which you will see in cut section the different components, like you will see here the piston rod seal, piston rod guide, and after that piston rod container tube. So this is a pictorial practical pictorial view, and is description that we have already seen in the previous slide. Now let us understand the operation is completed. As we have seen, this operation in two cycle. One is called compression cycle and second one is called an extension cycle, which is also called as a bound and rebound cycles. After that, we will see about gas filled shock absorber. Why we need, in case of a fluid shock absorber, there is a rapid movement of fluid between the chambers causing foaming. So foaming is the problem, which results in a lag because the piston moves through an air pocket which offers resistance. Foaming results in a decrease of damping and loss of spring control. Pressure increases in front of piston and drops behind it. Therefore, we use the gas filled shocks, which are designed to reduce the foaming of the oil. Construction is similar, except the double tube here used, a dividing piston is used. Two chambers are there, oil chamber and gas chamber. In the current scenario of automobile industry, the need of vehicles which provide smooth and comfort ride is growing. Nitro shock absorber are designed to be the ultimate in performance and comfort. In our country like ours, whose roads are not up to the world standards, the need for automotive components like nitro shock absorber are necessary. This figure indicates the different components of this gas filled shock absorber. There is a upper and lower mounts. We'll see at the top there is upper mount, at the lower side there is a lower mount. Hydraulic chamber containing the hydraulic fluid, gas chamber containing nitrogen at 25 bars, and dividing pistons. So there are two compartment, one compartment or chamber for hydraulic fluid and another compartment is for gas chamber. The piston rod is moved into the shock absorber, which dissipates the oil. This causes the dividing piston to press on the gas chamber, reducing it in size. While returning, the gas pressure returns to the dividing piston to its initial position. The pressure decreases behind the working piston cannot be high for the gas to exit from the oil column. Thus, the gas-filled shock absorber operates without foaming. There are two types of gas-filled shock absorber. One is called monotube with high pressure and twin tube with a low pressure. And it is having the following advantages: better fade resistance, instantaneous response, better durability, and no need for readjustment. So these are some of the advantages of such type of absorber. These are some of the references. You can have more information from these links. Thank you very much.